So the title of my research paper is Psychological Insights in Anuradha Roy's The Four-Day Delve, in which I will study the psychological reasons behind the actions of the characters in the novel The Four-Day Delve. So before we move on, let me tell you little about the novel The Four-Day Delve. It is an evocative and deeply moving tale of a young woman, Maya. She is a Hindu, but she marries a Christian man. The issue starts from here, on which the entire story has been woven. On this, her father disowns and disinherits her. She was very broken on such decision, but still manages to live her life happily with her husband. But then her husband also dies in a mountaineering expedition. On listening to this news, her heart broke into pieces and she was left all alone. She settles in Ranikhet and there she faces hardships. So the paper deals with various psychological undercurrents present in the novel, and my motive is to know and recognize both the emotions of human life and conflicts of them. So by knowing the psychology of characters, the patterns of thinking and humans can be detected, which can be very useful and applicable in practical life. Actually, actions of humans are not just like that. There is a driving force that works behind them. Something happens inside, only then it appears outside. So what is that driving force and where does it come from? This is my research objective to find out. Some psychological issues, characters that we meet at novels, and to find out that how coincidental they are with the psychological issues of people of contemporary world. So The Folded Earth is such a beautiful novel which is full of variety of human emotions. True that it deals with the superficial aspects also, like feminism, patriarchy, societal pressure, bad politics, betrayal, inequality, racism, etc. But with those superficial aspects, it extracts psychological aspects like loneliness, want of freedom, preclusion, fear of loss, defense mechanism, betrayal, self-esteem, depression, anxiety, insecurity, catharsis, hysteria, and so on, very beautifully. So this novel is actually a great combination of social and psychological facets. So because this paper is a study of psychological insights, so I have taken several psychological aspects to study on, like loneliness, fear of loss, longing for freedom, self-esteem, and dominance, respectively. You won't believe, when I was working on these things, very new things came in front of me, and that's why I think it's amazing to work on this genre of psychology and literature. Because here people who generally look like victimizers are victims themselves, and victims of their environment, victims of their own emotional conflicts, victims of their compulsory truths related to births, and sometimes victims of their gloom and suppressed emotions which are deeply absorbed in their souls. Psychology helps us know the realities of lives. After knowing it, we fill with pity. We sometimes even come to know that people who look like exploiters are even weaker. So therefore it becomes more interesting. And so loneliness, the most important phenomenon of the novel as well as of human lives today, this aspect makes our study more interesting as it is related to our own lives. Today we have everything, so many friends on virtual platforms like Facebook, Instagram. Then what is that thing which is hollowing us from inside? Why we feel so lonely? Why loneliness takes place, and why it has become a burning problem of 21st century? As Redo and Maria says, feeling alone is a growing phenomenon in modern and postmodern society. It is likely to become more widespread in near future and requires an urgent solution. So why? Maybe Folded Earth can give you some insights about it, as it is filled with instances of lonely people. As at one place, Maya, the protagonist, says, "I felt utterly, absolutely alone. Wrapping up my arms around my knees, I held myself as body shook with sobs." Maya was not the only character who was facing this hardship of loneliness. Several other characters are also there who were facing the same. In fact, V, Maya's beloved, who seems as the betrayer in the novel, also feels lonely in his life. Sometimes people who hurt others are themselves hurt. Bad circumstances are responsible for their bad tendencies. As Apchap and Demio say, when children experience loneliness along with abuse, neglect and abandonment, the strength of isolation can affect children the same as soldiers experiencing post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD. So this petition can help you understand the reasons behind enemy's behaviors. Of course, we don't get any direct lines about loneliness from Veer's side, but we can infer his loneliness by Maya's words. She says about Veer, he was sent from the house of one relative to another as a child, parceled out between them. How by magic he would know where he belonged and would have a real home. Actually, Veer did not have any identity. He didn't know who his parents were. So further, she says about him, about Veer, how Veer had hungered for affection and never found any. How I had yearned to comfort Veer in his loneliness then. So Veer's uncle Diwan Sahib was also an isolated man. Maya tells much about his nature of staying alone. And her mother, on the other hand, Maya's father also feels lonely much. Her mother died of loneliness, we can say. And because from the day when Maya's father disinherited and disowned Maya, her mother could not live her life happily. As Maya tells, the only thing she dreamed of now was a glimpse of me, and after that, death. How pitiful the situation is, you see. Poor mother cannot meet her only daughter due to prohibitions from her husband's side. The other most important psychological aspect of the novel is fear of loss. It should be really discussed about, as most of the characters are victims of fear of loss. Here I am mainly talking about fear of losing loved ones. Maya is afraid of losing her husband Michael and later her beloved Veer. We can have a sense of Maya's fear when she says, I felt a cloud of dread grow and darken as the day for his departure neared. When Maya's husband Michael was about to leave home for mountaineering expedition, maybe she was scared too much. She did not want to lose him. And later, as the plot develops, Maya becomes fearful of losing her beloved Veer also. Other characters are also victim of this fear, like Maya's neighbor. Amma is afraid of losing her granddaughter, Charu. And Charu is afraid of losing her beloved, Kundan. So that is why it becomes an important aspect to talk on. Fear of loss. A fear of loss of dear one can be a factor for one's insecurity, as Horney also explains about it. She says, in adulthood, losing a trusted partner is devastating. A series of losses can cause a giant spike of fear to grow as you age and can lead to outright terror of losing someone you love. And it is true. Yes, it happens with Maya because she loses husband. So fear of loss takes place in her heart very deeply with time. And same happens with Veer also. Veer, Maya's beloved, he also loves Maya so much. He loses so many people in his childhood, but that's why he leaves Maya lastly. So, and now let's come to the next point, that is longing for freedom. It is also a talkable aspect. We know that freedom is a primary need of any creature, so nobody likes to compromise in his or her freedom. So in fact, compromises made on freedom can cause maladies in a person. Although we think that we are free, and sometimes we don't know about ourselves also. We have some deep desires in our subconscious mind which consciously are unknown. When anybody puts barrier on somebody's freedom, then reactance takes place in the mind of such person. Such person wants to react in such a way as if he is trying to proclaim it to the world. I am free in my actions and you cannot put any limits on my freedom. Such person takes resistance against command and tries to restore his freedom back. But sometimes the actions taken by him are so subtle that even he himself does not know of this unconscious resistance. For example, Maya may does not want to do anything against her father, but still she does. His father was contemptuous of Christians, but still she marries a Christian man, Michael. Now let's take a moment to think about it. Who provoked Maya to do so? Maybe she was driven by her subconscious mind. So Maya appears to carry subconscious feelings of being pressurized by her father, as her father was dominating her from childhood. He pressurized her to be a businesswoman and a wife of such a man who could be ready to come to his home to take care of his business and legacy. But maybe Maya was reluctant towards his decision, therefore she chose to be what she wanted to be in her life and married to a man, a Christian man. Probably she felt danger on her freedom Thus, she used this technique of reactance unconsciously and restored her freedom finally. These lines of Maya can give you an understanding of such elements like dominance of her father. Maya tells about an incident when she says, I was no more than 7 years old and he pulled me out of the chalk grid of hopscotch game and introduced me to some visiting grown-ups with a flourish. See, Maya's father is saying all this. Meet the princess of Begumpet Pickles. One day she will become a first female industrial magnate of this country. She will live here and run business and I will arrange husband for her who lives with us. So dominant attitude of Maya's father is clearly, he can sense that he puts Maya's freedom on compromises, which is not good for mental and emotional health. So now let's come to the next point, that is self-esteem. Although it can appear as not much important facet, but it is important. Self-esteem is Maya's self-esteem of Maya's father turned her whole life. Just for the sake of maintaining a high self-esteem, her father took wrong decisions throughout his life. He pressurized Maya on every level of life and made her life distorted finally. He disowned Maya. Due to these reasons, Maya faces so many hardships in her life. She faces mental and emotional challenges like loneliness, depression, anxiety, fear, and maybe hysteria too. She became a victim of low self-esteem, and Abraham explains about it. Low self-esteem has many different manifestations like withdrawal, depression, and lack of self-confidence. So to maintain a high self-esteem, Maya's father did not care about Maya's self-esteem. He never took interest in her hobbies and always imposed his interest onto her. Another psychological aspect which plays a vital role in the novel is dominance. I guess till now you must have taken an idea of Maya's father's dominance. As you see, Maya's father dominates Maya mostly for everything, and her father's dominance is evident when she says, from the day my father had found out, Michael no longer allowed me to leave the house, not even to go to college. He put a stop to friends, outings, telephone calls. See, so much more content is there which shows Maya's father's dominance. He showed his dominance on his wife too. She was not permitted to meet Maya at all after Maya's exile, and this separation lastly brings her to death. What a pitiful situation it is. So dominance can be proven disastrous, as it can create emotional knots in human beings. Dominance is a feeling of sovereignty for the person who dominates, as they relish a feeling of autonomy. But studies show that people don't acquire dominance with interest, rather they acquire it due to some necessities. Actually, dominance becomes their need to survive. What a point! You may wonder to know this, that sometimes dominance is a fake attitude which overwhelms people, and sometimes the dominant person bears even more pain than that of dominant ones. According to Cummins, there are 5 indicators of dominance. I'm talking about it very briefly. Rank of discrimination, acquiring social norms, monitoring compliance with social norms, monitoring reciprocity, flouting social norms through deception. So these 5 cognitive functions can be seen in Maya's father's dominance also. He makes rank discrimination, as he says once about an employee, that man you sacked was serving no purpose. Secondly, he acquires social norms because he banishes his only daughter on marrying a Christian man. So he maintains this by monitoring compliance with social norms and monitoring reciprocity also. And finally, he fulfills the last criteria of flouting social norms through deception, because he shows that he is contemptuous of all Christians, but still he wants to get his child educated in Christian school. What a double standard. By the way, he was not dominating only for his daughter and a wife. On the other hand, he was dominant for everyone around, as Maya tells. He was the natural born lord. He ruled over factories and fields and 2 younger brothers. By the time I grew up, I was as afraid of him as his brothers were. So now I'm concluding. So after discussing all the psychological aspects, we become able to understand some new hidden facts which generally remain behind the curtains. Psychological study makes us able to differentiate between false and truth. It casts light on innate reasons of the things, and sometimes what is seen is not true. and what is not seen is true. This kind of a study can give us an opportunity to relate our situations to the situations of the characters. So we can know more about ourselves, as it can provide an opportunity to catharsis. So it can help us understand emotions, realize suppressed emotions, and also release emotions. So if we don't know ourselves, we cannot know others also. So it can support mental well-being. Thank you.